Hey guys, in this video we're going to go over how to use the 11 rack editor. This is a standalone piece of software that allows us to edit the 11 rack rigs and sounds and a few of the other settings. We can use this to save rigs to our computer, manage the inputs, and even load different 11 rack rigs that we downloaded from the internet. Before starting this video, just make sure you checked out the previous ones in this series where we covered setting up the 11 rack and editing a rig on the 11 rack itself. To get this set up, we first need to download and install the 11 rack editor from Avid's website. This won't automatically install when we connect the 11 rack. Then we can run the program with the 11 rack detected. If it's not detected, try rebooting the 11 rack, checking the connection to your computer, and rebooting your computer if necessary. Now that it's set up, let's go through what the 11 rack editor can do for us. This software can control basically everything that we can from the 11 rack, but it can make it easier in some situations. On the top left, we can access the tuner and user options. With the tuner, we'll see the guitar tuner on the computer screen and we can tune from here instead of looking at the 11 rack screen. With the user options clicked, we get more options down below, such as our amp settings and signal routing. Below that, we can select our rig input. We can set it to guitar, microphone, reamp, or a few other things. I use the guitar for the first recording and reamp when I'm reprocessing the signal. On the top right, there's the buttons to mute the headphones and main outputs, and to adjust the master output level. This will affect the recording level as well, so be careful with that. The main section down below changes our signal chain. The first section on the left is the rig selector. We can use this to choose a rig, and the button to the right allows us to save the rig over another rig. Next is the True Z, which affects how the input is detected and makes the 11 rack respond more like a guitar amp than some other direct boxes and amp simulators would allow. Next we have the rig volume, tempo, and what the expression pedal controls if there is one connected. Down below we have all our effects and amps. The top part of the table, where it says the category of effect we're using, can be clicked to turn it on or bypass it. When it's not colored in, it's bypassed. When colored in, it's active. The drop-down below allows us to choose what the effect is in that slot so we can select the different distortions, delays, and modulation effects like we did on the 11 rack itself. We can reorder the parts of the signal chain like we did on the 11 rack. To do this, just click and drag them. When we click on a section of the signal chain to select it, it will appear in the bottom of the window. With the 11 rack editor, all we need to do is click and drag on the knobs to change the settings. The amp and cabinet settings are a little different. If we select those, it will show our amp and cabinet in the bottom of the window. Above the amp, we'll see the controls for the gate threshold and release. Click and drag these to change them to cut down on some of the noise. Then there are two drop-downs to select the amp type and the cabinet. With user options enabled, we can choose to link the amp to its corresponding cabinet. On the right, we have the output level control. The amp has controls such as bypass, a bright switch, gain, volume, and EQ. Down below we have speaker controls where we can bypass, add speaker breakup, change the microphone, and set the microphone to on or off axis. Now let's cover how to use additional rigs for the 11 rack that we've downloaded off the internet. There are many websites available that provide specific rig downloads you can use, and many of them are designed to match an artist's rig as best as possible. The quality of these rigs will vary, but there are quite a few available to choose from. First find the one you want to use online and download it to a folder on your computer. From the 11 rack editor, click the button to load a rig. Then go to load from computer and select a file. The 11 rack editor will load it as active. Then you can choose to save over another rig if you would like to with a button on the right. This allows pretty much unlimited different rigs to be used with the 11 rack, even if they can't all be stored on it at the same time. Thanks for checking out this video on the Avid 11 rack and the 11 rack editor. If this video helped you out, don't forget to give it a like, subscribe to the channel, and press the bell icon to get notifications whenever a new video is released. You can also check the video description to get an 11 rack and for social media links to stay up to date on all our new content.